Okay, so we now have to solve this differential equation. I'll teach you the method of solving this particular. It's actually very simple, okay? And the method is like this. So let us start with the solution. The first thing you have to do is, there is a standard form that you have to compare it to. The standard form of this type of equation is of m dx plus n dy equal to zero, okay? So you have to compare with the standard form. So compare with standard form, you will get m is this m dx, right? So m is this value here. So the m is 4x plus 3y minus 4, and the value n dy. So compare that and you'll get n as this, and n is equal to 3x minus 7y minus 3. Okay, that's the first thing. You will compare with the standard form. And as soon as you compare with the standard form, the next thing you will do is you differentiate m partially with respect to y. Okay, so m you have to differentiate with respect to y. Just remember it's cross. M is with dx, but you differentiate that with respect to y. N you differentiate with respect to x partially. Okay, let me do that. M differentiate partially with respect to y. That means you have to treat y as a variable and x as a constant. Now 4x, the x is a constant, right? It's a partial derivative. So the 4x becomes 0 and the derivative of 3y is going to be 3, and 4 is anyways constant. So partial derivative of m with respect to y is going to be 3. And do that, partial derivative of n with respect to x. And that will be, first one will be 3x, derivative of 3x with respect to x is going to be 3. And these things are going to be 0. Okay, so you've got the value of dou m by dou y, which is 3. And dou n by dou x, that is also 3. So you write down a statement. You say that since now dou m by dou y, the value, and dou n by dou x are equal, okay? Therefore, this is exact equation, exact differential equation. So the equation that we are that is given to us is the exact differential equation. And whenever you have exact differential equation, the solution of that equation goes like this. The solution of an exact differential equation can be written as integration of m dx plus integration of n dy equal to c. That is how you can write down the solution. And just remember that there are some conditions. With the first integral, you take y as a constant. And here, when you write down n, that you take free of x. Okay, I'll tell you what I mean. So while you're writing this as a solution, let me write this down. It is going to be, let me continue writing here. When you are saying integration of m dx, this is m, right? This m dx. So that is going to be 4x plus 3y minus 4 dx. And remember, your y is constant over here for the first integral. And when you're taking the second integral, you will take, write it as n dx over here. And then you will take n values of n, which are free of x. There should be no x in that. Okay. So you can't take 3x. You can't take this number. You can't take this. But you can take minus 7y and minus 3. So let me write that. It is going to be minus 7y minus 3. Okay. You should not write any x over here. I hope you get that point. And dy is equal to c. Okay, so now this is a normal integration. We just have to integrate this. Okay, to keep in mind, the first integration they will have y constant. So the integration of 4x is going to be 4. The integration of x is going to be x squared by 2. That is the integration of x. And then y is anyways constant. So it's going to be 3y. And then this is going to be 1 dx. So the integration is x and minus 4x. Right? And the next one, it is an integration with respect to y. So this will become minus 7y squared by 2 minus 3y, okay, equal to c. Now let us write this down once again. I can club these two terms, can I? Right? So let's just like simplify this a little bit. The answer is going to be 2x squared. The 2 cancels out. Then I will write, or just write it like this, 3xy minus 4x. Minus 7 by 2, this term, y square minus 3y is equal to c. And now this is the solution or the final answer of the question. So this is how we have solved a differential equation and we got the final answer to this one. I hope you followed this.